Hello everyone, this is Mothership here, and today I'm going to be reviewing The Best of Both Worlds, the Season 3 finale and Season 4 pilot of Star Trek The Next Generation. And I'm going to go over why I think it is one of the very best Star Trek two-parters, Star Trek stories, ever. So, the plot is that the Borg have destroyed a colony, and now the Federation knows they have begun their invasion. So, Starfleet brings Commander Shelby on board, who is a Starfleet officer who's been studying the Borg, and she's discovered ways that they could possibly defend themselves against the Borg. So she comes on board the Enterprise to help them get ready for the situation. Now, at the same time, you've got the subplot of Riker being offered his third commission for a starship, but him, again, not accepting it. Now, this had been first set up in Season 2 with him just not taking his own commands, but here we actually see repercussions for this because Commander Shelby wants to rise up the ranks, and she would definitely be the first officer on the Enterprise, but Riker's getting in her way. He's stopping her from getting up to this high position. And throughout the episode, he's wondering, why can't I captain my own starship? What is wrong with me? Why am I just staying here? What's keeping me grounded here? Why don't I want to leave? And it's interesting because then it ties into the main plot in part two when Picard gets assimilated and he has to captain the Enterprise for part two and gets the actual field commission of captain. So he's got to deal with being forced into that role. Now, Picard's assimilation into the Borg Collective is something I'll get into later on in this review. But actually, for now, I want to talk about Shelby. I think it's a real shame she didn't stay on the show, because she's a great character, she's got a really good actor, so she's played really well, but she just never came back. She was never even brought back up again. And it's a shame. I think she really fitted in and could have made a fine addition to the crew, but oh well, didn't happen. Now, the Enterprise is sent to go distract the Borg cube. So it's really cool the way the Borg can communicate with the Enterprise and all. And the Borg have a much better voice than in Q Who, thankfully. So now, the Borg chase the Enterprise into the nebula. Now, they're stalling for time here, so that a fleet can basically be assembled to take on this Borg cube, and so that colonies can be evacuated and so on. But the nebula has thunderstorms that begin erupting and they strike the Enterprise, so they have to leave it, and Picard gets kidnapped by the Borg and taken onto their cube, and the Borg explain that they need somebody to talk to humanity, somebody that humanity can relate to, to assist assimilation. So they assimilate Picard, and the cliffhanger is Picard, or Locutus as his Borg designation, appearing on the Enterprise's view screen and telling them that resistance is futile and they will be assimilated. And that is Star Trek, The Next Generation's first cliffhanger. It's the first cliffhanger of a series ending. Now that would be come somewhat defining for the Rick Berman era, and this strategy would continue to be used in Voyager and Enterprise, where you'd end a Star Trek series on a cliffhanger as part one of a story, and the next series will pick up with part two of that, and then you'll properly get into the next series, which is what happened here. It happened for the rest of TNG, didn't happen for DS9, but it happened for most of Voyager and a bit of Enterprise. And so it became, you know, kind of Star Trek's go-to strategy for ending a series. And we see that starting here, which is cool. This episode has great music. Ron Jones did such a good job with the music. It's got, like, proper blockbuster soundtrack, and it really just has this tone of being the end game for TNG, like a really good bit where TNG was coming into its own, and this kind of symbolized that. So Yeah, part two has had some criticism because it falls flat in some people's opinion to part one. And I guess I can kind of understand where they're coming from. I think it's pretty much just as good, maybe a little weaker. I will be honest though and give them this, that the rescue of Captain Picard, most of it is really cool, but the fact that Picard was just standing in a corridor and just basically didn't do anything, like Locutus didn't do anything to resist being beamed back onto a shuttlecraft to be taken to the Enterprise. Yeah, that was dumb. But part two still has amazing moments, like the scene where the Borg cube is just drifting through space and then the camera turns and we see it entering our solar system. It's amazing. It's got such an epic feel with the music flaring there. Or the scene where you can see multiple Federation attack fighters going after the Borg cube, and they just get vaporized within seconds as it continues on its course to Earth. And at the very end, where the Enterprise arrives at Earth, and there's the Borg cube is just hovering over it, sitting there. So cool. And the soundtrack elevates it to just another level. Like, seriously, this is some peak Star Trek. I have this episode, like, engraved into my brain. I remember it so well, I didn't need to rewatch it for this review, but I love it so much that I decided I would anyway because it's another excuse to rewatch The Best of Both Worlds. This episode, to me, is the very best Next Generation episode. Like, two parts. Like, it's the best Next Generation story. And easily stands as one of the best Star Trek stories. Not only did it help give us a better understanding of the Borg, it also expanded on Picard's character. Because, he from now on carried a bit of this trauma that you'd see surface every now and then in First Contact, in I, Borg, or in the next episode after this, Family, which is another one of TNG's best episodes, but this one easily takes the cake of best episode of TNG, which is why I'm going to give The Best of Both Worlds a 10 out of 10. So join me next time, where I will review I, Borg.